Good morning. Welcome to day two. I'm just having my breakfast at the King's Head. I found the only sunny spot in the little beer garden here for the time being. So today is Monmouth to Llangattock Lingoed. Apologies if that pronunciation is incorrect. It's about 14 miles, I think. It's, what is it now, 7:45? So I'm going to have this, nip back to my room. I'll be setting off about 8, and I imagine just after 8. I've got to stop at the Waitrose on the way and grab some food for the day. And then make tracks. So I'm just walking through the centre of Monmouth. There's plenty of places to stock up on food, to get food at night. If you've forgotten anything, there's a mountain warehouse and a millet. So plenty of places to get stocked up on stuff if you should need to do. The only thing I'd add to that is I said I was going to go to Waitrose to get stocked up. I passed an M&S first, Marks and Spencer, so I nipped in there and got my stuff. And it's a good job I did because Waitrose is actually closed at the minute. I'm just approaching Mono Bridge. Out there. This gate was presented by the 9th Duke of Beaufort to the Monmouthshire County Council in 1900. I might need that later. I love it where you get these little streams that run under the properties. Very popular little area with dog walkers, it seems, as you leave Monmouth. I've got my first climb of the day. I'm heading through what I think must be King's Wood, surrounded by trees and chirping birds. I'm not sure if the video really gives you an indication that I'm climbing up or not, but I guarantee you I am. The sun is out, it's warmer than yesterday, which is probably due to the fact that the sun is out. It's supposed to be a decent day, I think. Cloudy at times, but no rain it's looking like. Oh, that's a steep bit. But yeah, beautiful morning. 3 miles done today. If you've seen my previous two long distance hikes, the coast to coast and the Snowdonia Slate Trail, you know that I tend to do a mixture of B&Bs and campsites, mainly campsites, but just a couple of B&Bs to break it up, to have a relaxing comfy night and to charge all batteries and things. So when I was planning this one, which was February, mid-COVID pandemic, I looked at doing the same thing. So I contacted the three B&Bs, booked the three B&Bs that I was going to stay at, then contacted 8 different campsites, one for the night before, then every night of the walk. But of the 8 campsites I contacted, only 2 got back to me in the first week and said that they weren't taking campers this year. They were like, one was a pub garden, I can't remember the other one, it was a small site again. One other one did get back to me the week later, that was Pampunton, somewhere that sounds like that. And they said, yes, that'd be fine. None of the others got back to me, which I guess I understand because it was mid-COVID pandemic and we didn't know what was going to happen. But with that, I decided to look for B&Bs through the lot, and they were able to book rooms on the sort of premise that we were going to come out of the pandemic and everything was going to open up again, which it has, thankfully. Okay, not everything has opened up yet because that's June the 21st and we're only on June the 6th. But yeah, I've decided to B&B the lot, so I'm going in luxury this time. Right, I'm going to have a couple more minutes, have a drink. I might crack open my bottle of Coke that I've just bought at Waitrose. I have bought 2 days food as well, actually, because although I'm staying at the pub tonight and I can get food there and breakfast there, there's nothing between here and there I can't see that I can get food, so I've got today's lunch. And then tomorrow, I can't see anywhere between the pub and Hay-on-Wye, which is where I'm finishing, that I can get food. So I've bought today's lunch and tomorrow's lunch whilst I was in Monmouth. Right, I'm gonna have a quick drink and then we'll get going downhill after that brutal climb, sweating. Better get that because it says King Offa's Lodge. So, Orchard campsite was just there. There's more bed and breakfast and camping all over around this little area. So you're not going to be stuck for places to get accommodation around here. Do we take this risk? So, where am I then? I'm going to be somewhere here, am I? Where am I there? So this is, I'd quite like to go through it, although there's no actual abbey left by the looks of things. This is the site of the Greystew Abbey. So I could take the road detour to avoid the mud, or I could take my chances. It has been quite warm over the last, well certainly the last week, but yeah, the last couple of weeks. So hopefully it won't be too muddy. Right, so once upon a time, before by the looks of it there was a big fire, this was the site of Greystew Abbey. Often fell victim to attacks from Welsh raiders and is thought to have been burned to the ground in 1233. It was always poor, failing to generate the wealth of the abbeys. Hatlanthony and Tintern. It was dissolved as part of Henry VIII's Act of Parliament in 1536. I'll put the QR code on in case you want to have a scan and have a look at it. So that was somewhere over here in this field, but it's not anymore, so there's no point looking at it. A rather randomly placed picnic bench, very kind of the farmer. Very kind of him to cut this grass around the edge as well. So thank you, Mr. Farmer. Or Mrs. Farmer. As ever, a signpost is spot on. That looks like a relatively new signpost, to be honest, isn't it? We've got a poorly leg. Buzzard circling. I'm not a big churchy person. I mean, the architecture of a church impresses me, the way it's constructed and whatever. Let's go in. But the name of this one absolutely impresses me. Hello, Mr. Squirrel. Plenty of them around today as well. So this is St. Michael's Church of the Fiery Meteor. How about that? So I wonder if these trees that are planted in perfect rows are Christmas trees. There's quite a lot of them. There's another field over this way. So, if this is anything to go by, then my last comment about the potential Christmas trees is completely wrong. I think these are apple trees. Not that I can see any apples growing on them, so I might be completely wrong with that. That would suggest, yes, apples for cider. Quite a lot of trees in there. Well, I don't particularly want to try and pronounce the Welsh because I'm bound to cock it up, but I'll have a go. Llantilio Cluseni. And that's where I'm just passing through at the minute. I am almost 9 miles into today. There's one out of these outside Chepstow Castle as well. It's people who were chosen to represent Wales. Oh, I think we might have some kids in here by the sounds of it. Hear them screaming. Echo. This is White Castle. Not quite so white as it maybe once was. I'm going to find somewhere to sit and have a sandwich, probably before I show you around, because I'm starving. Perfect spot. Quite a drawbridge. But there once was. See the remains of stairs. There's a few other people about, as you'd probably expect in a place like this. Overgrown on the outside, but I think you still get the idea, don't you? So I assume there's access up to this bit up here, but I think the gate's locked. Him. Hello little fella, I'm not coming to disturb you. Very yellow and pink and squeaky if you can hear my rucksack. How's that for you? So just under 0.2 miles left to do today, and what way to finish it? We've got to climb. Typically, I'll be ready for a pint when I get to the top of this. Made it! And I've just seen the sign on this gate and it looks What a perfect place to line. Brilliant. 200 metres to go. Oh. I'd say it's coming to look at the church later. Out of three. Looks like I'm the only one staying. Let's see if we can find anyone.
Oh,
hello. So this is where I'm staying tonight, at the Hunter's Moon Inn. In Llangattock Lingoed. Again, I apologise for my pronunciations. It's a very nice little beer garden here. And I'll show you around the rooms in a minute. There's no signal here, but I've just got the Wi-Fi code. It's actually pinned up on the window up there, so that's very handy. Right, so this is my room today. I've had a box room, I've had a huge room, and now I've just got a pretty standard sized room. Does the job. Double bed, a telly, dresser, shower this time, no bath in this one. But yeah, does the job. Let's test the bed out. I've not got an air yet. Oh god, that's comfy, that's soft. Yep, sound. So 15.6 miles that's coming in today. I did do quite a bit of walking around the castle, so yeah, say 15 miles on the trail. Gotta wash them somewhere. Soften them up a bit, they've gone a bit crusty. So that's me hammock and chips tonight at the Hunter's Moon Inn. Take care, folks. I'll see you in the morning.